sports. It's in the game.
You attacking, better stand back and watch a run. Shotgun come with the option. Send big blitz, nobody blocking. Big win, that's a ring and a watch. And when he come in the slot, trying to bend the corner, your limb game. That's your partner, then your twin game. All you want to do is talk, I don't need talk.
Gotta hurry, somebody talk.
I can pull up with that, Chewbacca that. Banging my chest and my head on the lock. Feeling like walk a flock of flame. I put the opposition out the game. I'm out of the pocket, but I rock with the game.
Salute when you see me. That jealousy is an ocean, and you either float or you sink. Moment of truth, credit check, you not approved. BB King, I'm in love with the blues. Don't start me up, I got finishing moves. Look, salute when you see me. Slid through all the commotion, it's breaking news, they got an ad on TV. Popping out all of my politics, and probably in a section where you not permitted. My honey's matching my Dodger fitted, playing all goal, ain't no stopping in it. Look, salute when you see me. I bought her a CC, and that was her purse. Disgusting with. Do for a purse, disgusting with do for the clout. I'm one of the realest, the real ones can vouch. They thought I was done, but all I doubt. You gotta play my next round. Salute when you see me. Put in the car to the my runner gets you speedy. Still thugging like the days when they weren't hearing my CD. Made it out of the trenches. Just salute when you see me.
Yeah,
salute when you see me.
I'm getting greedy, I blow the whole budget on me. That's on me, I'm conceited. Treaty, nah, that ain't how we treat it. This right here sound like a three-peat. I put the dip in, it sound like I'm knee-deep. I'm like, oh, you too needy. Me and HB going Juvie and BG. They gotta put my face on the box of Wheaties. I'm praying for whoever think they compete. Salute when you see me. That's all he ever, so that's how you greet me. I'm going TM101, cheesy and pussy.
Hello, everybody. I'm your host, The Coach. Well, you may have had a great draft, but that doesn't guarantee a victory. It's time to settle this mud draft game on the field.
The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. Fielded right around the 8. And they'll start this drive just across the 30. Pretty nice work on the return. So here come the Ravens with their first look on offense. Leading them out, the rookie from Ohio State at 22 years of age, it's Justin Fields. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. A play fake, now Fields to throw. Flushed out right. And his first look is incomplete.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
To throw again on second down, Fields. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete, so the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
Throwing on third down, Fields. That's complete to DK Metcalf. And he will have a Ravens first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. From the 50, here's Fields.
Steps away to his left.
He's got his all-pro receiver, Michael Thomas. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. The catch and run going to wind up netting him 33 yards.
All right, Charles, let me put you in the head of one of those defenders out there. You have a big play like that go against you so early. What does that shake your confidence?
It shouldn't, but it often does, because your thought process all during the week is how you're going to get after that offense and make your plays. And when they make one against you, it makes you a little bit hesitant.
Time to regroup.
The first carry now for Dalvin Cook. Looking for a crease, can't find one. Stopped at the line of scrimmage. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down.
Now Fields.
Being chased out left. And that is caught, but he will
will come down out of bounds, says the side judge. Incomplete.
It's been a good opening drive offensively thus far, but you know they don't want to waste it and settle for a field goal attempt after that incompletion. So this is a big play coming up here on third down.
Now it's Fields. Flush to his right. Open man, Lamb. It's complete. And in for the Ravens touchdown. CeeDee Lamb from 17 yards out. And the Ravens take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Let's make no bones about it. On paper, they're the better team. They're at home. That's a strong opening drive.
And just think how many times we've seen this type of a matchup. Just what you said, better team at home should steamroll them. And we've seen it go the other way. Sometimes, though, they buy into it and understand we are the better team. Let's go out and prove it right now.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And here comes a return from just beyond the goal line. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. So out come the Cowboys under head coach Mike McCarthy. They'll be piloted by their veteran quarterback now in his ninth season in the league out of NC State, Mike Glennon. The first carry for the Memphis man, Antonio Gibson. Nowhere to go that time. Might have gotten a yard up to the 25.
They'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here, and if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
Granted, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion that would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync.
And the Raven pressure too much. Down he goes.
Well, how about that? A dime set on defense. Six defensive backs. None of them blitz. They're just back there in coverage. Defensive lineman gets the sack.
That's where the O-line, they go to the sideline. They keep their helmets on so the cameras can't find them, right?
Yeah, the cameras can't find them, but I know one thing. The O-line coach will.
On the return is Lamb. Oh, a nifty juke there.
Not much fun for a guy trying to tackle it.
But a nice return that time gets 12 yards back. And the Ravens, they'll take over. Baltimore set to take over here for their second possession of the game. And certainly they'll be hoping to hit pay dirt like they did on the last drive. Got the football back, so a chance to go up two scores.
And they haven't been tentative at all in this ball game, because sometimes you start a game with your script to try and get information out of the opposing defense. How will they play you in certain situations? Sometimes you script to attack, and that's what I'm seeing so far. Nice play there to force the incompletion. And to me, one thing's for sure. When you're the underdogs and you're playing on the road, you absolutely have to get takeaways. You've got to get the ball from them.
Yeah, win that turnover battle, going to be key. They didn't get one there, but you get the feeling they keep making plays like that, they might just get a few.
Yeah, once you get one, defensive teams think they come in bunches.
And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down. So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a third and 10. Back to throw, Fields going for Metcalf on the deep ball. And that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down. The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. They snap it to Fields. Oh, looking for Waller, but this is intercepted. Picked off at the 48, and the return across midfield and to the 46-yard line. Now Glennon. The connection here with Nelson Aguilar. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and two. Ahead of the chains now, second and two. Glennon. This time for Smith, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 34. And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. A few things better than a big man interception. You can always tell right when they get the football, there's that level of excitement and nervousness, and also like, what the heck do I do with this thing?
And you say, no better sight? Well, not for the quarterback who just threw it. It's bad enough to throw a pick, but throw one to the big guy? But you're right about that. Now what do I do with it? But what's fun about it is, you know they're going to be in the film room after this ball game, telling all their teammates, maybe I should shift over to offense. I've got skills. What do you think?
Oh, absolutely. I always find myself cheering for them after they intercept it. Unfortunately here, he couldn't make it into the end zone. Fields on first down. Looking long for Thomas. Touchdown! Michael Thomas, 42 yards. And the Ravens are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. He put quite a bit of air underneath that touchdown pass. Of course, we knew that he had the strong arm.
That part was easy. You could see that throughout his college career. But what you want to know about a rookie is, when the pressure's on, can you throw with touch? He just did right there. And boy, it was pretty.
McManus's point after is good. And it's now 14 to nothing. Kick this one away, and off it goes. This taken in at the goal line. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Here's the Dallas offense now, heading back out onto the field. And they're in an early hole. The first drive, they threw the interception. That led to a touchdown, so decent-sized deficit early on.
It is, but I think you hit the key words, early on. So they have to decide, do we even need to change game plan, or do we just need to execute better and try and get back in this game?
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And his crew will take over at their own 45-yard line. Second straight drive now here, Charles, that have ended with an interception.
And I just wonder, because I don't think it's going to rattle him necessarily, but I also wonder if it's going to nerve him a little bit. Does it lead to another one?
And now this is intercepted. My goodness. Eddie Jackson picks it. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down.
That was nice work there defensively to force the incompletion. Now, even though this drive started in plus territory, they're still not in field goal range yet. So they can work towards another couple of stops and not allowing that turnover to hurt.
On second down, it's Gibson. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. It'll go as a loss of a yard, so now they deal with third and 11. Another example right there how this defense really is winning the entire game at the point of attack.
Yeah, right there at the line of scrimmage, because they are dominating it. It allows their interior guys to get upfield and spill into the backfield. So how are you going to combat that? You know, because they bring in your tight end, keep him in, your running backs, they have to step forward. Bottom line, your offensive line has to block them first to give yourself a chance.
5 yards, not enough, and it'll be fourth down.
We can make this one pretty simple. Locked up all of his progressions downfield, forced to get it to his running back, but how about the way they ran to the football and knocked it down to force a fourth down?
On is the punt team now as this one's sent away. And they'll play keep away from the returner as this one will be marked out of bounds at the 13-yard line. Pretty good spot. From the 13 now, they work on first and 10. And you see Dalvin Cook and the offense heading back out. He only has a single solo carry, one. Numero uno, second quarter. They need to get in the ball more, don't they?
I'm not the greatest statistician in the world.
Yeah, you are.
But a back like that with only one carry kind of takes me back to college in the classroom. Not enough evidence to declare what you should do the rest of the game. Give him the ball some more and find out.
Will they incorporate him? It got his man complete. And all the way in for a Ravens touchdown. Michael Thomas, 87 yards. And the Ravens will add on to their lead. Solid response that time by a young quarterback. Last drive, interception. This drive, the touchdown pass.
I like how you described it, solid, because you don't get extra kudos for bouncing back if you're going to be a big-time quarterback. You're supposed to do that. But at the same time, when you're a rookie, that's not guaranteed, is it? Sometimes they hang their heads and they go in the tank a little bit. Not in this case. Bounced back, took his team downfield, and threw a touchdown pass.
So they go with a pass there on the two-point try and able to convert it, Charles.
And a good job by the offense figuring out their two-point play and using it well. It's interesting how people are using the strategy nowadays, though, isn't it?
It really is, and I don't know how much that one, that particular play, factored in, but with the PAT moving back in 15-16, that kind of changed things, didn't it?
It's really a part of everyone's strategy now. When I talk with coaches and when we sit with them, they always talk about they actually had two-point periods in practice now, something they never really did before.
About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
No gain on the play as we have reached the two-minute warning. 2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. We remind you that coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will be alongside. He'll have highlights and analysis from Orlando of this first half of action. They'll set up the screen for Gibson. And this effort won't be enough as they rally up to stop him a couple of yards short. The screen gets seven, but it's not enough, and it'll be fourth down. Here's A.J. Cole now as he's on to punt for Dallas. He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. Lamb to return it. A 77-yard punt return. And the Ravens are able to widen their lead here in this first half. And we always talk about kick returns being so exciting on kickoffs. Punt return almost equally exciting.
And typically we talk about the kickoff return being the most exciting. Exciting 5 seconds in football. It's a great, glamorous, dashing play.
And now they'll empty the backfield here as they elect to go for two. They'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. And they are just not going to let up as he is into the end zone here for two more. And that was the old QB one-man band play there on the conversion.
And look, let's face it, even quarterbacks who don't have great mobility, in certain situations, they're able to actually take the ball in themselves. Remember way back when Joe Namath against the Giants at the Yale Bowl, right? Remember Joe had all those knee operations, they thought he couldn't run it? No one accounted for him. He practically walked into the end zone.
This fielded right at the goal line. And not much happening on the return as he'll get this to about the 23. A look at the running back, the man out of the backfield as he gears up to go again. They've given him some touches. They haven't had a lot of success on the ground. Do you maybe keep going to that well, or do you mix it up more?
I think you mix it up more, try and loosen things up. Get the defense to react to other people, other plays, but don't forget about it. That's your horse. You know, Secretariat lost twice in his career.
So educational. That's very true, kids. Look it up. To throw again on second down, Glennon. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That second down play nets a minus four.
This pass broken up. The contact well timed there. And now fourth down.
Well, this first half has not gone according to plan so far offensively, or even defensively for that matter. They could use a big-time spark somewhere, but it's not going to come on this drive as they have to punt this one away.
Fielded at the 33. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. Good blocking there, nearly sprung him. As it is, it'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Ravens set up well to begin their drive as it'll begin in enemy territory already. First and 10, here's Fields. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. And this is caught. And in for the Ravens touchdown. Michael Thomas on his way to a monster game. Three first half touchdowns. And the Ravens continue to pour it on.
So whatever happened to rookie quarterbacks taking time to adjust to life in the NFL? Because this guy looks like he's been doing it for about, what, 7 years? Four touchdown passes? That's not something rookies are supposed to be doing with the ease in which he's doing it.
Extra point from McManus is good. And a route is on here in this first half. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Taken in at the 3. And he brings this out past the 20 to the 24. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they've got less than 30 seconds to go here, so not a lot of time to work with. Glennon's throw there taken in by Smith. And he gets this up just shy of the 30 to the 29 before he's out of bounds. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. He'll drop to throw. It's caught by Aguilar. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. 7 yards there and a first down.
When you're struggling on offense, you're looking for anything possible to get you going. Sometimes you do it like basketball teams that don't normally press. You put a press on, bring people to life, make them move a little bit quicker. Maybe that'll help them as they head towards the half.
Lennon's throw pulled in by Aguilar. Now the Cowboys going to burn the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 11 seconds remaining in this first half. Looking to throw again on second down. Glennon, that'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock. These guys have punted 4 times already, and they're staring at a fifth, barring a conversion here on third down. And that is incomplete, stopping the clock with 5 seconds to go. The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's fourth down. And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. They'll throw now on the final play. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And for the third time here in this half, it's intercepted. Xavier Rhodes with a pick. And he will be brought down as time is now run out on this first half of action. So we've reached halftime here in what is quickly turning into quite a rout as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach? All right, hang on. We'll jump over halftime. It's the Cowboys who get the football first, and they trail here as well as we resume action in the third quarter. Taking it about the 1. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line. Mike Glennon now, and the rest of this offense heading back out. And that first half was nothing short of a disaster. 0 points on the scoreboard and a big three in the INT column.
So they've got to get him going, obviously, right? So you've got to get him in rhythm, and we always think of short passes. I think of jet sweeps where they just kind of toss the ball forward. You know, that counts as a forward pass. And then you can say to him, look at that. You completed 3, 4, 5 in a row. Now you've got to get your confidence going.
Give him 9 there on the first down completion. And here's a give to Gibson. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard on the play, so now they need 3 yards on third down. Looking to throw. And that is incomplete.
How about some applause for the defense there? They forced him to throw that one into coverage, and just like that, they're staring at a fourth down. Well done.
Here's A.J. Cole now, as he'll come on for his 5th kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. Fielded at the 20. That'll go as a punt of 42, 7 on the return. And possession will switch hands, 1st and 10. Now we'll see what Michael Thomas and the rest of the offense has in store here. This defense, they wouldn't mind not seeing him again for a while. 3 trips to the end zone. How about that?
I think right now they would happily go to their general manager and say, is there any way you could get a trade for him? Bring him over to our team so we don't have to cover him anymore. Because he is really having a heck of a ball game, isn't he?
Boy, he is. I don't know that mid-game trade's going to happen, but good thought. To throw on 2nd and 10. Fields escaping the pressure right. Looking long for Thomas. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far. It brings up 3rd down. From the gun on 3rd down, Fields. Flushed out right. On the run, he'll let this go deep right side. And unable to connect. Incomplete. Give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up 4th down. And no move to get the offense off the field. Despite failing once, they're going to go again here on 4th down. And for a 3rd time tonight, he's intercepted. Eddie Jackson picks it, and he's going to return it to the 21-yard line. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now 3 interceptions in this ball game.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's a guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
On 2nd down, here's Gibson again. And once again, they stop him behind the line. Great job by this Ravens defense. Just a loss of a yard there, but it's not going to help. Now they face a 3rd and 14. They're going to look to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's 4th down. And his kick here is good. And they'll get back 3, but this remains a large deficit. The bottom line, tremendous starting field position, really squandered there as they wind up going backwards and then come up with just 3.
Well, getting the 3 turned out to be important. I can imagine the head coach, when he ordered the field goal, please salvage something out of this drive. That was not fun to watch.
This one taken just inside the 10. Oh, a good-looking return set up here. And a good effort on the return there. Gets him across the 30, up to the 33. The Raven offense set at the line for this next drive.
And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. And on the left sideline, he caught it, but out of bounds, according to the head linesman. Incomplete. So the ball a little late getting there, and it's third down. Now they face a third and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. From the gun, here's Fields. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
Got a man open. It's Darren Waller. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. They've been burned twice already on fourth down, but the third time's the charm as they keep the drive moving.
So first and 10, and if they score on this drive, might have to start digging in our second half blowout material.
Fields throw caught here by Metcalf. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. To throw is Fields. He'll let this go for the end zone. Got a man, it's caught for a Ravens touchdown. DK Metcalf, 34 yards. And the Ravens add on. Little loft on that touchdown pass and sort of dropped it in the breadbasket perfectly.
Right in the bucket. And when you're coming out of college and you're a rookie in the NFL, sometimes you forget about the different types of throws you have to make. You just rely on your fastball and throw it as hard as you can all the time. But in this situation, he understood and threw it in a spot where only his receiver was going to get it and no one else. That was pretty.
McManus's point after is good, and the lead will swell by one more. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. From a couple yards deep, he'll bring it out of the end zone. And he'll get it up past the 20 to about the 22. The Cowboys offense heading back out and ready to go again. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That good for 21 on the catch and run. One play has him up past the 40 already, and another first and 10. They'll try the left side with Gibson. And they're able to swarm him behind the line, and his rough night continues. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Three quarters in the books. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. On second and 12, Glennon, and he'll complete this to Gibson. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. They get 7 there on the screen. It'll set up a third down. Now back to throw. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
Here's A.J. Cole now, as he'll come on to kick for a sixth time tonight. He gets this away as he'll wisely, I'd say, angle this to the sideline. Michael Thomas now heading back onto the field. And I think we both agreed he could have a really good game with this matchup, but over 200 yards now.
I don't think we saw it as that good. And I think what really makes it special is when games like this are occurring, it's not just getting locked in and in the zone and on a roll. It's continuing to adjust throughout the game because, you know, the defense is kicking coverages towards him, trying their best to slow him down, and he keeps getting the better of
them. Yeah, whatever they've done, it hasn't worked.
And he's going to have a Ravens first down as he's got this up to the 45-yard line.
They'll try and wind down some clock with Cook. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40.
And that's why Dalvin Cook is the Minnesota Vikings' featured back. You put the ball in his hands, good things happen. Second in the NFL last year in rushing with 1,557 yards, and that's now back-to-back 1,000-yard seasons with 30 combined total touchdowns. What a player is Dalvin Cook.
He was brought down by Brandon Copeland. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Eddie Jackson picks it. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. These guys had to punt their last possession, and that's become too familiar of a refrain. Too many of these drives just wound up going nowhere.
Well, you know how in baseball, when the pitcher gets a base hit and he's on base, they bring his jacket out to him to keep him warm? A lot of times the punter goes to the sideline, puts on sweatpants or a wrap over his leg to keep it warm. He might need a massage from the trainer right now from all the work he's getting.
So the Cowboys in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. Throwing over the middle, and it's incomplete. Well, it just seems like all game long, there hasn't been a lot of sync quarterback to wide receiver on this side of the football.
They haven't been on the same page, quarterback and receivers. Heck, they haven't been on the same grease board when you draw plays up.
And for the fourth time tonight, it's an interception. Picked up by Xavier Howard. And he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line.
Well, partner, I got to tell you, I'm trying to think of something positive to say for this offense, but I'd have to be a spin doctor for that one. This has been a tough performance to watch.
And I think it's hard at this point to actually identify what's really gone wrong. I guess the catch-all is everything. Doesn't sound like real sharp analysis, but I don't have much else for you.
And the scoreboard just lopsided, and it's been ugly from the get-go. A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Again, it's Cook. Runs over it, and he'll go down here at the 12-yard line. A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. Now it looks like he'll throw here. They'll roll him out right. To the end zone, but it's incomplete.
The incompletion there stops the clock. Any surprise they're throwing here late?
Ordinarily, yes, because you would think enough is enough. They've got plenty of lead, but I've seen this a bunch of times as well. The defense can crowd the line of scrimmage. If you just hand it off inside, you're getting your running back popped a lot as well. Sometimes the defense dictates it. If they're going to crowd it, you may have no other choice but to throw it downfield.
Flush to, and they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. They've already been on record as saying, hey, if our rookie quarterback's going to tuck it and run on a scramble, we kind of hold our breath. Well, that was a maybe no, yes, as he's able to get into the end zone.
Are you saying he's got to learn where the line is about whether you keep your eyes downfield, try and find a receiver, or you tuck it and go? And I think there's going to be some growing pains with that. I think in this case, he made the right decision.
And we know he's got the speed. He showed it there. Extra point from McManus is good, and that will extend this big lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Taking it about the 1. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. The Dallas offense back out onto the field. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And the coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on.
And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him.
The rookie from Michigan, Quiddy Pay, paying first-year dividends with a takedown there.
One final shot. They'll look to throw. And this is dropped and incomplete. Well, there's a metaphor for how this one has gone as time has run out on this ball game. A big offensive explosion helped leading them to victory. And the defensive guys, they're just saying...